Hey guys, what's up? Last time we finished Omashu, and now it's time to move on to the inside of Bumi's palace. In this episode, we're gonna basically finish the whole palace, at least the main parts, which are the main hall with Bumi's throne and the table with all the food on it, and the newly refurbished chamber that was once bed. We begin blocking out everything. In case you don't know what that is, it's basically for us to know at what scale we are working and which modules we actually have to sculpt. So we're gonna start out with the main hall, and we're actually gonna block out the cave too, which is seen in the first challenge, but that's gonna be moved to another scene later on. So we're gonna do the wall pieces, the floor and ceiling pieces, as well as the chamber sculpts with bed, table, all the food in the center, the carpets and the chair, the lamps, the ceiling carpets that are seen in one shot in the show. And also for the main hall, we're gonna sculpt the big flags and the big long carpet, as well as the throne, table, the tablecloth and the table chairs. And at the end, we're gonna move on to sculpt all of the contents that are seen on the table, such as the teapot, the cups, a fish, a bread, sushi, Bumi's lettuce leaf, a big cooked pig, and the chocolate fountain as seen in the show. This is the second video in which I have multiple streams in one video, so let me know how you think that is and how that flows. We actually have a couple more rooms we could do, but that are never seen in the show, so if you have any ideas what kind of rooms we could add to the palace, let me know. I was thinking about like a kitchen area and like other chambers and stuff like that. So yeah, let me know in the comments what you think about that. And in the next episode, we're gonna move on to the first challenge from Bumi, which is the cave and the waterfall inside it. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you soon, and bye bye. Stay safe and wash your hands.
Thank you.